Hello everyone, this is Rick with Cybermedics, and we're here today to talk about BitWarden. In particular, the BitWarden Premium Organizational Plan. So let's get started. Before we do a deep dive onto the organizational plan, I highly encourage you to click on the video above, which detailed the BitWarden free plan and how to secure it with a YubiKey. So that would be a good one to start with if you're not familiar with BitWarden. On this screen, it compares the free, premium, free org, and family org. We're primarily going to be interested today in the free org and family org plans. So as we scroll down here, you see there's a maximum of 6 users on the family org, unlimited collections, which are basically folders underneath the organization for sharing information. You can encrypt text and files, and you can secure with a hardware YubiKey and also use an authentication app. And you get all this for $40 a year, up to 6 people. So now we're going to log in to the Gmail account associated with this, with the BitWarden extension. And you can see it has recognized that this account is in the BitWarden vault. So all we have to do is press Ctrl-Shift-L, click Next, Ctrl-Shift-L again, and you're logged into that account. And now you'll click Next, and you'll see it's logged in. Clicking login here for the BitWarden account, we'll type in the email address, the password. It will ask us for the security key because this account has been secured with a YubiKey security key. We'll touch that, we'll click continue, and we're logged in. And one thing I want to point out over here is this will change as we go through this demonstration as owner and user, so it's important to note what is the account that we're actually logged into. Now we're going to talk about organizations. What are organizations within the BitWarden ecosystem? They're basically a group of people for sharing information, and there is an owner with that organization that has the rights and privileges to assign users to the organization. So first thing we're going to do is we're going to create a new organization. We're going to give it a name. We're going to type in the owner's billing address. Scroll down to the bottom and hit submit. And now you see we've added this test team organization, and the sync home organization was the default. So this is, when we talk about organizational types, the family organization with up to 6 users is this top one, and the free organization one we just created allows up to 2 collections and 2 users. All right, so now we'll click on the test team organization. And we're going to manage people by adding a user to that test team organization. So the first thing we did is we created an organization, and now we're going to manage people by inviting a user to that organization. So we invite them, we type in their email address, scroll down, and you could add them to a collection at the same time. We're not going to do that. You also have a couple other options, but for now we're just going to invite the user. Now you see they have been invited. So we're going to go to the My Vault, and we're going to manage people. We're going to add a user. This time we're going to do a custom user on the Sync Home organization. So the first time we did a common user on test, this time we're going to do a custom user. So we click on Sync Home, then we click Manage, and then we're going to say invite a user, and it's the same process. Type in the email address. This time we're going to select custom, and custom gives us a whole bunch of privileges that we can select, and the one that we're going to select here is going to be under manage all collections and allow them to create collections, and then we're going to press save. Now we're going to minimize the owner account and see what it looks like on the user side of things. Now please note here, this is who's logged in, and then also on the left side of the screen, what will be important is what organization we're in. So we're going to minimize this, and this is the email that the user will receive. They will receive Join Organization Now. You'll click on Join Organization as the user who was invited. You'll type in your email address, your master password, you'll log in, and now you can see the invitation was accepted by the user. So we'll minimize this, and what does it look like on the owner's side? They will get an accepted notification both in email and within the app. At that point, the owner can come over here and confirm. So once you have accepted and confirmed the user, we'll minimize this again and see what it looks like on the user side of things, and you will see that they have a notification that they have been accepted. So we'll minimize that. And now they have two organizations, Sync Home and Test Team, that they have been added to. All right. We'll go back into the owner account, and now we're going to talk about collections. So far we've added an organization, and we've added users to the organization. And all right, so we click on Manage and Collections. And collections are to be thought of as folders with two important distinctions. They're folders for the holding of all of the information that you want to share. Anything in the vault can be shared across the organization in a collection. So organizational owned items are assigned to users, and those items must be in at least one collection. So if you're going to have something in an organization, it must be in at least one collection in order for it to be part of the organization and shareable across the organization. So we're going to type click here with new collection, add a collection, type the name of the collection, test collection, and save. So collection has been created. Now you'll see underneath the test team organization that we were in, we have created a test collection. So the next thing we want to do is we want to manage that collection by putting credentials inside of it. So we're logged in as the owner. We created the test collection. Now we're going to go to our vault, and we see that there's one item that we've created, a credential that is unassigned. So we're going to select that item and then put it in a collection, and we're going to select test collection. So we press save. Now that item is no longer in the unassigned category, but now it's in the test collection. We're going to manage collections and add users. So we click on manage, and then we select collections here, and then we're going to click the test collection and come down and select users. So that was the process. Users, and then we select the user that we want to add to the test collection, and we press save. Now we'll minimize this, and we'll go into the user account, and we're going to manage the organization where the user adds a collection. So we're going to go to, this is under the user, right? And we're going to go to My Vault, and we're going to pick this organization up here. So now this is the user, and he logged into the Sync organization. And remember, when we added this user, we gave them custom privileges to be able to create new collections. As the owner, we did that. So we'll get rid of this, and we're going to just click here with new collection, give it a name, and press save. And as the user, we have created a new collection underneath the Sync Home organization because we were given that privilege by the owner. Right, so now, but if we click on this, you'll see we have no access to do anything to it because that's, we don't have any permissions. So we'll minimize this, and now we'll manage the collection by allowing the owner to add some credentials. So this is the collection that the user created, but now we're in the owner account under the Sync Home organization, and we're going to add credentials. So we're going to go to the vault, and we have this credential here, Pinterest, that's unassigned. And then we're going to go over here and click collections, and we're going to put it into that use YubiKey collection that was created by the user. Press save. And now it's no longer in that collection. It's been moved into the use YubiKey. Now we'll go over to the user account. We'll go into the vault and show you that even though the user was not given any editing privileges, I don't know if this is a defect, but you can select this. This is the user, right? They couldn't do anything to add, but except to create the collection. Now we're going to click delete, and it says, do you really want to send this to the trash? And you say yes. So that thing has been deleted. There are no items here, so it deleted the thing. So user deleted credentials. So not only did they delete it, but now we're still in the user account, and this is the trash can. We select this, and we come over here, and we say, do you want to permanently delete it? And it's going to say, we can say yes, and it's permanently deleted. So that is a little bit scary, because the user was only allowed, supposedly, to create collections, and they were able to go in and delete the credentials. So they were able to delete the credentials. And remember, they were supposedly only able to create collections. So how do we prevent deleted credentials? We go into the owner's account, click on the sync home organization. We click the user, come down here, and we want to manage the permissions. So the problem with these screens is that there's more. As we scroll down here, you'll see that there's extra information that's not on the screen. So when you first look at it, there's a lot of things down here at the bottom that you don't see. So the safest thing to do is when you add that user, to put the user on read-only and hide the passwords. Now we can press save, and that user will no longer be able to delete credentials. So let's move back into the user account, and we've added this into the vault, and we'll show you that they now, if we press delete, we say, do you want to move this to the trash? You say no. You no longer have permissions to be able to delete anything. So that's a way of preventing that from happening. All right, back into the owner's account, we're going to now talk about how to manage collections and move credentials. Let's say you decide you don't want to share something and you want to get it out of a collection. It's a lot more difficult to get it out of a collection than it is to get it into a collection. So what you're going to have to do is be in, logged in as the owner, go to the organization, find the collection that you want to move the credential out of, click the gear icon, and the first thing you're going to do is clone it. Now when you clone it, you're going to have to scroll down here, and you're going to have to select the owner's email, and you're going to say save. Okay, so now a new item has been created, and it is not in this, it's in the vault of the owner. So we'll go to all items, and we'll sort by PIN, and now you'll see there's two items in here. This is the original one, and it's in the use YubiKey sync home collection, so we'll just hit cancel here. The cloned one it's not in the sync home organization, and it's not in the test team organization, because when it was cloned, it's put into the root, if you will, of the owner's vault. So we'll just hit cancel here. And now we'll go up here and we'll delete the original credential that was in that collection that we wanted to move it. And now it's gone. And you see we in our vault we have one item. So that in essence we moved it out of that collection, out of that organization, through the process of cloning it and then deleting the original credential. That's the process. Now if we come down here and click the use YubiKey sync home collection, you'll see there's no items in the list. Okay, in summary, we talked about organizations, explained that they were a way to share information, logins, files, anything that you can put in your vault. We talked about how to create a new organization. We talked about the organizational types, the default 6 family user collection with unlimited collections, and the free with 2 users and limited to 2 collections. We explained how to add a common user with no privileges. And then we talked about how to add someone with custom privileges. Then how to create collections, and the details of collections are they're basically folders underneath the organization for sharing information. Users are assigned to those by the owner. Once the owner assigns them, they are managed by the organization, and all organizational owned items must be in one collection. We showed how to add a collection. Talked about managing collections by putting credentials into the collection. We showed how you can add users to those collections so that they will have the rights to see what is in each of the collections. We went through the process of the owner adding credentials. We showed the user potentially deleting credentials. Detailed how to prevent a user from deleting credentials. And finally, managing collections by moving credentials out of a collection and keeping the original information. Let us know if you have any comments or questions. Hope you will consider subscribing, and have a great hack-free day.